we were going to be presenting a case about psychiatric pediatric OCD with anti-thyroid antibodies and hypervitaminosis D3. This was a 13-year-old female patient who lived in Tularam, who was an 8th grade student and from a 3rd class socioeconomic status. Her chief complaints were weight gain and excessive sweating and episode of sudden muscle cramps in the last 3 years, and she had anxiety with repetitive actions in the last 2 years. The patient was apparently asymptomatic 3 years ago, and she gradually gained weight for over 3 years. She complained of excessive sweating even at rest since 3 years, and she had sudden muscle cramps, 3 episodes in her right hand, sudden in onset, since 3 years. She feared contamination from mud, sticky substances that might make her sick, so she led her to repeatedly wash her hands over and over again. She was actually diagnosed with hypothyroidism, TEDME, and hypovitaminosis D3, and she was on supplementation. There was no history of fever, there was no previous medical history or previous family history. She had started her Menarche and she had a normal diet. On exam findings, she weighed 48 kgs with a height of 140 centimeters, BMI of 24.48, which is high. She had acanthosis that was present and hyperpigmentation over her fingers. She was sweating in both of her palms. There was no thyroid swelling, and vitals were stable and systemic examination was normal, and her speech was also normal. She presented with obsession and compulsion and depressed mood, but no ideas of worthlessness. She had intact judgment, and no delusions. Investigation showed an increase in TSH levels and an increase in T3 levels, but a decrease in prethyroxin and vitamin D3 levels. There was normal B12 and blood glucose levels. And after she came back to the OPD with OCD symptoms after 2 years, she was diagnosed for autoimmune etiology and found that anti-TPO antibodies and anti-thyroglobulin antibodies increased for over a threefold of the normal value. Other investigations like ECG, liver function test, electrolytes were all done and they were normal. Parathyroid hormones, serum calcium level, and phosphorus were also normal. The differential diagnosis is hypothyroidism due to other causes, hypoparathyroidism due to other causes, and OCD due to anxiety disorders. The diagnosis is Hashimoto's thyroiditis and hypovitaminosis D3, and the diagnosis of OCD was made on the DSM-5 criteria with a total score of 26. The pharmacological treatment was treatment for vitamin D3, which was cholecalciferol, levothyroxine supplementation. Her thyroid profile improved for 2 months after she was on supplementation. For the OCD, she was prescribed fluoxetine. And for cognitive therapy, she was on exposure response prevention therapy for over 8 sessions, each session lasting for 40 minutes. And she was also on vitamin D3 supplementation. Follow-up at 4 months showed a decline in the OCD score with a total score of 10. She stopped taking the fluoxetine due to nausea, but she still continued the ERP therapy. The importance and objective of our study was to screen patients with Hashimoto's thyroiditis and vitamin D levels that can act as a potential biomarker for OCD diagnosis. So there have been numerous studies shown that if you treat a person with vitamin D supplementation and Hashimoto's thyroiditis and make their thyroid profile normal, they won't likely get OCD. But in our case, she actually was on supplementation and she came back after 2 years with OCD symptoms. These are my references. Thank you.